Today, we are going to review another brand new stereoscopic 3D 360 camera, the Live Planet. The Live Planet is designed for 3D 360 and 3D 180 live stream, with supposed to be the best stereoscopic effects for human eyes. The camera has 16 lenses to make sure there is no blind spot in stereoscopic stitching. And the stitching is all happen inside the camera without needing any post-production. It has automatic HDR video feature to increase the dynamic range. Subjects supposed to be able to get close to the camera, closer than any other camera currently out in the market. Its max resolution is only 4K, and it has a pretty hefty price tag, almost $10,000. Right now, both YouTube and Facebook does not really support 3D 360 live stream in 4K. So Live Planet built their own platform for 3D 360 live stream that use view optimized cloud streaming, live stream technology that far superior than Facebook and YouTube. In this video, we will find out everything about this camera, what I like and what I don't like, and what I really think with real-world test footage, and image quality comparison between Live Planet and the Insta360 Pro 2, Kandao Obsidian R, and another best live stream camera, the Samsung Run right here. Let's dive right in. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. If you are watching this video, I assume you have decent knowledge about 3D 360 camera and looking for a reliable 3D 360 live stream solution. Live streaming is the best way to make money right now in the 360 industry. It does not require any post-production, but it does require camera reliability. A lot of the professional 360 camera now in the market are not so reliable in long hour recording. They will freeze or overheat or shut down during the live event. So let's take a look at the Live Planet, a 3D 360 live stream camera that designed from the ground up for live streaming. It's an end-to-end live stream solution. What it means is that you don't need to purchase extra switcher, SDI cards, expensive stitching computers, or software to have a successful live stream. Everything is built in, so it does save you lots of money and headache, and less chance for hardware or software failure by simplifying the whole process. This is nice to have if you have any experience in 360 live stream using the Nokia Ozo or the Samsung brand. Let's talk about the image quality. This camera is very, very small, but with 16 lenses. More lenses than the Google E Halo. And judging from the Zcam V1, E Halo, and Samsung RAM, more lenses usually mean better stereo with better stitching. But this camera is only 4K, which is kinda low in 2019. Again, resolution does not mean anything if the image quality is good. So let's compare the Live Planet with some of the popular 360 camera in the market to see if it hold up. So here is the side-by-side comparison. From left to right, we have the Live Planet, Insta360 Pro 2, and the Kandao Obsidian R. First thing you notice is the Live Planet has a bottom blind spot. It cannot capture the tripod area, just like the E-Halo. The image is also not as sharp compared to the Insta360 Pro 2 and the Obsidian R. Let's zoom in and take a closer look. Now you really see the difference. If you watch my latest video on max resolution of Oculus Go, I mentioned at the end of the video that 8K downsampling to 4K will always look better than 4K direct capture, no matter what your final output resolution are. This is a prime example of that statement. Even this video is 4K 3D 360, but since both Insta360 Pro 2 and Kandao Obsidian are capable to capture 8K, the image will look clearer and sharper than light planet. There are also a couple noticeable blur spots, pixelated edges, and chromatic aberration, as I point out in the video. Now, let's see the stitching. You will need to watch the actual test video in 360 or in a VR headset with YouTube VR to really see the stitching quality. Click the link in the top right corner to find that video. In around 2 feet when I circling around the camera, you can see noticeable optical flow artifacts in both the Kandao Obsidian and the Insta360 Pro 2. But not the light planet. Light planet, no doubt about it, win the stitching. But the chromatic aberration is getting worse when crossing the stitch line in the light planet. So I hope they can fix that in the new firmware update. Now let's take a look at the stereoscopic quality. Here is a screen grab of the light planet in anaglyph. Here is side-by-side comparison with the Insta360 Pro 2. As you see, the distant object, which is the white wall, should have minimal parallax and definitely should not have any vertical parallax. Light planet did exactly that. But Insta360 Pro 2 has pretty bad vertical parallax. So the stereoscopic quality is definitely better in the light planet. Just to point out, here is the Kandao Obsidian R, and Kandao also did a great job in stereo quality. As you see, no vertical parallax on the white wall as well. Just a word of warning, if you want a solid stereo stitch to create good 3D, use Mystica VR, not the Insta360 Stitcher, and fix the vertical parallax issue in post. So in conclusion, light planet no doubt has the best close distance stitching, make it the best live stream option, but probably not a camera for regular 3D 360 production. Both the dynamic range and the image quality are not as good as the others. And 4K just don't cut it. It needs more resolution and bigger sensor to just complete with the Insta360 Pro 2 or the Kandao Obsidian. Resolution and image quality is not always the determining factors for 3D 360 production. Until this point, provide a live 3D 360 preview on set in a VR headset like that. For director and the client, it's non-existent. In a professional film set, not be able to show what the final image looked like to the director or to the client on set who pay you for the job is a huge problem in cinematic VR. Asking the director and the client to trust you, the DP, is not always possible, especially for director or clients that never done VR before. Showing them live what you're capturing give them confidence to direct and to buy in for the final product. When clients see real 3D of what they pay for, it's always great for production. It really involves the client in the creative process instead of blind trust. So if a budget allow, I would definitely suggest get or rent the light planet and put it on top of your bigger professional 360 VR camera to just to get a live feed out to show your client and director on set. Other feature that make light planet stand out is, first, remote control of camera from the cloud. Second, open camera API so you can integrate your VR app or your live stream solution with the camera. Third, simultaneously streaming to multiple platforms like in Samsung VR, Facebook, and YouTube at the same time. It is actually a very important feature and probably why you will buy the light planet. No other camera can do that right now, at least not natively. 4. Integrated speed test and stream health monitor, which is always nice to have. One big feature on live stream is view optimized for the Asian cloud streaming. Light Planet used advanced algorithm to predict head movement to enable VR video stream over LTE network by using 80% less bandwidth. So potentially, you can still see 4K or high resolution stream even with very slow internet connection. This is so important as most people nowadays still do not have a very fast enough internet speed to watch 360 video in 4K. So all they left up is a very ugly stream, which is very not ideal and make 360 live stream a laughing stocks. This technology can potentially change that. So what about the thing I don't like about this camera? Well, Light Planet is only 4K. $10,000 for a 4K camera does not sound like a good deal in 2019. It does not have internal audio recording ability at all. You need to pair it with a Zoom H2N or H3 VR, which is a hassle. It does have a little fans to keep the camera cool, and you can hear it sometime in a live stream. It still requires an Ethernet cable and a power cord to work, and do not have an internal battery solution, which make it hard to use outside of the studio environment. You will need a D-Tap cable and V-Log battery or a Go mount battery to run the camera. The amazing Light Planet livestream platform is not free. You get $10,000 credit when you start, but still, charging for platform fee for a camera that costs a fortune is probably a little bit too much. Thank you for watching this in-depth review of the brand new Light Planet VR livestream camera. It is not over yet. The next video, I will compare it with the Samsung RAM. And I will do a real livestream with you guys on this camera, so you see the quality firsthand. If you want to learn more about Light Planet and tutorial series on how to do a successful 360 VR live stream with Light Planet or any other 360 live streaming camera like the Samsung RAM, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Please like and share this video, and I will see you next time. VR Creator Level Up on Creator Up.